Hi, welcome in, Katie.
Hi.
My name is Dr. C. I'm going to be taking care of you today.
Okay.
Tell me a little bit about what brings you into the clinic today.
I'm having a lot of foot pain. I'm a runner, and I switched to a new pair of shoes a few months ago, and they seem to be working really well, but it just kind of came out of the blue. I've been running more, so that's been resulting in some blisters on my toes and feet. I've also had a few social events I've gone out to and worn kind of crazy shoes, and this is kind of bringing some wear and tear in my feet, so I'm feeling pain, and then I have some skin issues too.
Okay, that definitely sounds like something that you should be a little bit aware about, so it's a good thing that you came in today. And you said you've been noticing this pain for a few months now.
The last month or so, I'd say.
Are you concerned about this being anything other than the blisters and the pain? Is there any underlying pain that doesn't seem quite usual?
I don't think so. I don't feel any like sharp pain. Like, it's not excruciating. It's just really, really sore and uncomfortable, and sometimes it hurts to run.
So, okay.
Yeah.
Have you considered taking a break from running for a bit?
Not yet, but I will if that's your determination.
Okay. And just to go ahead and add some things into our chart here, what is your date of birth?
Sure, it's March 24th, 1988.
And have you taken any new medications within the last 6 months?
No.
Have you had any major surgeries within the last 6 months?
No.
Any trips outside the country in the last year?
No, unfortunately.
Okay, Miss Katie, we're definitely going to go ahead and take a look at you today, get to the bottom of what's been causing your pain.
Okay.
For now, you can go ahead and relax. I'm just going to go ahead and do your blood pressure and your vitals.
Okay.
We also have our little emotional support kitty Enzo here if you are looking for a good boy to give some love in.
Okay.
Okay. Go ahead and relax. I'm just going to start off by taking your temperature. Okay. We have 98.6 as your temperature. Now we're going to go ahead and check room. What am I trying to say? Room oxygenation?
Oxygenation, yeah.
Okay. And we're going to take a look at your oxygenation. If you go ahead and slide your finger in there and let it rest. While we're taking a look at that, you can go ahead and slide this. Give this to clinical assistant Enzo to hold on to for a moment. Go ahead and uncross your legs for me. We do have a healthy reading today.
Got it.
Can we go ahead and set these aside for now? Okay, as for oxygenation, we have good readings on room air.
That's a great sign.
Just gonna mark this into your chart. now all I can do is instruct you to pet the good boy as part of your treatment so far.
And then we'll do that gladly.
Take a look at the structure of your knees.
Okay.
If you wouldn't mind just sitting as you are with your knees extended over the sides.
Sure.
Of the bed there. Okay, Miss Katie. I'm just gonna go ahead and feel the structure of your knees to make sure that the joints here aren't creating any tension that would lead to the foot pain.
Okay.
Structurally intact. I'm going to go ahead and travel a bit lower, feeling your calves, making sure there's nothing tense or pulling while the feet are in rest. Does this cause you any pain?
No, not really.
Everything seems to be intact with the knees so far. I'm going to ask you to raise your left leg. Breathe and relax. Now raise your left foot. And relax. Okay, same on the other side. Go ahead and raise the base leg. Great. And then raise the foot. Everything seems to be aligned. This doesn't seem like the source of the pain, which is a really good sign. Mm. I'm gonna go ahead and ask you to lie down, and then I'm gonna take a look at your feet.
Okay.
Okay, Miss Katie. Just gonna go ahead and gently roll up your pants. Okay with you if I remove your socks?
Mm-hmm.
I love your nail polish.
Thank you.
Begin by gently palpating the feet, as well as conducting a visual exam. Any pain in the tips of the toes?
No.
Okay. Does this hurt at all?
A little bit.
Does this hurt?
No, just a little irritated.
Gotcha, I do see a little bit of signs of some blistering here. Most likely from the running that you mentioned. To point to your foot on your right foot as far as it can go. Great, and bring it back as far as it can go. Go ahead and just draw your toes up towards your chest if you can. Great. Now go ahead and point with this left foot. Okay, and relax. I see a light bit of scarring over here. Have you had a surgery on your foot in the past?
Yes.
Okay, Katie, go ahead and continue to relax. I'm gonna go ahead and measure different parts of the feet so that I can compare the swelling between them. Okay, I'm gonna have you gently raise this foot a tiny bit just so I can go ahead and measure the ankle. Okay. Now I'm gonna switch feet here. Okay, go ahead and raise your foot a tiny bit. Okay. So it does look like the right foot is definitely more inflamed than the left foot. For now, I'm going to go ahead and position your ankle to do some rotations. Gently rotating each foot in a circle. Go ahead and just relax. This might cause a little bit of pain and discomfort, but I'm just checking out the joints and the feet. Now they move together. Just going to raise up your leg and rotate your foot in a circle. Over to this foot. I'm going to raise this foot up, gently rotate it. Go ahead and spread your toes as far apart from me as you can. Great, now relax. I'm just going to go ahead and use my hammer to feel along the bones of the foot. I'm just going to gently run this along the other side of your foot to test the reflexes. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and do some measurements. I'm going to go ahead and do a visual inspection between between the toes, underneath the nails. Okay, Katie, I'm gonna go ahead and conduct a sensory exam on your feet.
Okay.
The first one is going to be either warm or cold.
Okay.
Just let me know if the sensation that you feel is warm or if that sensation is cold.
Cold. Cold. Cold. Cold. Warm. 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 Cold. Cold. Warm. 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 Cold.
Now we're going to be switching over to sharp or dull. This is what sharp is going to feel like. This is what dull is going to feel like. Do you notice the difference between those two sensations?
Yes.
Okay.
Sharp. Dull. Sharp. 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 Dull. Sharp. Sharp. Dull. Sharp. Dull. Sharp. Sharp. Dull. Dull. Sharp. 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 Dull. Dull.
Alrighty, Katie, now we are going to do left or right.
Right.
Do a bit of acupuncture therapy next.
Okay.
We're also going to be rubbing your feet with some lotion and some soothing oils, so hopefully this is going to be easing the pain that you've been having.
Okay, thank you.
I do have a nice and soothing eucalyptus massage oil. So I'm going to be gently dripping this on. Go ahead and have you switch onto your stomach. Okay, I'm going to be applying some acupuncture pressure into the soles of the feet. I do have a massage roller that has been dipped in rose water essence to help heal the skin and the muscles and tendons lining the foot. Our examination for the evening. I definitely like what we've discovered so far. It doesn't seem like anything majorly is going on wrong with your feet, but we are going to go ahead and schedule you a follow-up appointment next week so that we can go ahead and run some further testing.
Okay.
Thank you so much for coming in today.
Good night.
Good night.